In today's video, we're going to be looking at how to mix dark colours, or more importantly, why some people have difficulty mixing dark colours. There can be a number of reasons for this, and I'll go through each one in turn. The topics I'm going to list are not in any particular order. Just use the video as a checklist until you find the actual cause of your problems with mixing dark colours. In the last section of this video, I'll show you the process I use to mix the correct tone and colour before my brush touches my painting. This process helps me paint quickly and with clean watercolour washes. A common mistake is where students start mixing colours where they have a lot of water in their palette and they just look at the colour they produce. So if we look at this mixture here, it looks very strong. However, when you test the colour on a piece of paper, this is the actual strength of the mixture. So you can't go by what you see in the palette if you're trying to judge a particular tone. So you have to test it, and ideally test it on a piece of watercolour paper similar to the paper you're going to be painting on, because that gives you the closest representation of the colour and tone of the paint that you're putting onto your paper. As you're painting, you pick up water to pick up some paint, and what happens, as you can see what's happening here, you get water dripping into your paint well, and so you end up creating an area of very diluted paint. But when you look at it from above, that paint there looks just as strong as the dry paint. And then when you decide to mix a colour with that, so we'll put some water in my palette, you pick up some of this paint and you keep picking that paint up, that wet paint, and you can see how it just doesn't get any darker. The only way to make that darker is to pick up some of this drier paint and then you can increase the tone of your colour as much as you want. Sometimes students get into the habit of cleaning their brush too much. What I mean by that is they might want to mix some blue paint here, say. They pick up some of that paint and dip it in their paint well, and then they'll clean the brush, pick up more paint, and then put that in. And then they'll clean the brush, pick up more paint, and put that in. All the while, they're loading the brush with water each time they clean it. They're wasting paint in their water container, and because of all the extra water they keep adding, they never mix a colour that's very strong. Each time they pick up more water and paint, they keep diluting this mixture here. That's not common, but I have seen it happen with some students. Another thing that happens is, you can see my palette here. I have lots of paint in my paint wells. Sometimes when students first start to save money, they'll buy these smaller tubes, which is probably the most expensive way to buy your paint. But then, because of the cost of the tube, instead of filling up their paint well with lots of paint, they might just put a little dab of paint in their palette. And then what happens, they start, say, mixing a colour, and then they'll try and make that little bit of paint cover more area, and pretty soon the only way they can somehow increase the amount of paint they've got is by adding more and more water. And rather than adding more paint, they just continue to add more water. And the problem with that is the more water you add, the lighter a colour you will mix. So it's false economy to try to make a small amount of paint last longer. To paint good watercolours, you have to be prepared to use lots of paint. Another common mistake is when students clean their brush and then, rather than taking most of the moisture out before they pick up some paint, they leave it very wet. So if you've got a brush like this, it's fully loaded, the water is dripping out of it, and then you pick up your paint with that, it's already very well diluted. Whereas if you clean your brush, dry it on a towel, then you pick up your paint, you can pick up and quickly start mixing some very dark colours. Now obviously if you want a weak mixture, that doesn't matter. If you've got lots of water in your brush, it's something to be aware of, and just make sure when you do pick up the paint, you don't pick up that now wet paint, but pick up the paint from the dry area, unless you only want a very weak mix of paint, in which case by all means you pick up this wet paint. Here we're not talking about whether a colour is black or white. You vary these what are called values or tones by making sure that you vary the amount of water in your mixes, right? So if you want a stronger, darker tone, use less water. A lighter tone, you add more water. A common mistake students make when they're first learning is they mix every mixture with the same amount of water. And this tends to give them a very flat looking painting. So keep in mind when you're mixing your colours that if you want that stronger tone, reduce the amount of water in your mixture and that will give you a stronger tone. I'm now going to show you a process to use that'll help you get the right tone and colour before you start to paint. When I'm painting, I keep a sheet of watercolour paper on which I test my colours before I start my painting. Once you touch your paper with paint, that's when the clock starts and that's when you have to keep working. But before that point, you can spend as much time as you want mixing your colours, and that gives you a lot more time to paint because you've done all the hard work before you touch the paper. So my general process is I work out how much paint I want of a particular colour, I put that water in my palette, and then I'll pick up that paint. And I first work on getting the colour right, then I work on getting the tone right. In this case it's only a single colour, so it's only going to be French ultramarine. And then once I've mixed the puddle of paint, I can tell to some extent what its tone's likely to be because of the way the paint flows. But the real test is I might pick up about half a brush load of paint. I'll show you on this sheet. So the way not to test it is to pick up a brush with lots of paint on it and then just put a dab like that. Because of the amount of paint I've put there, it's going to look a lot darker than what it actually will be. The way to do it is pick up some paint, drag the brush through the edge of your palette and take out about half the paint, and then press lightly and drag the brush across. And you can see the difference between that tone and that tone. Same colour. This is misleading because this leads you to believe that the tone or value you've created is much stronger than what it actually is. This is closer to the real thing. In fact, when it dries, it will still dry a little bit lighter, but still it's much closer to the final tone than what this one is. Now you can spend as much time as you want getting all the colours right, and it's not uncommon for me to have all my painting areas mixed with different colours, a different brush ready to go, and then once that's done, I can paint very quickly. And it helps me produce some very clean watercolours. So I hope that was helpful for you. If you have any questions, please leave them below. And again, if you like the video, please subscribe and hit the notification button, and I look forward to seeing you for the next video.